The project I tried this time is a bird feeder. If you have kids, you may know Home Depot has a kids workshop on the first Saturday of every month. My kids love this event, so we never miss going to this event. This time it was birdie buffet. This is a very simple structure that can hold bird seeds. I thought it would be fun to attach a camera to it so I could observe the birds up close. I also thought it would be fun to show them to my kids, so I tried this project. Let's talk about the camera module I used here. This is a Realtek AMB82 Mini AI camera. It can transfer video and audio data together through the RTSP protocol very easily. It can also process object detection models like a yellow on device without internet connection. It already provides examples that works very well for these things, so it can be easily used in your projects. I have already done some projects with this camera and I believe they are also very interesting. So if you want to know about this camera, please check out the projects I did. I'm working on attaching the camera to the bird buffet that's already been built. I'm drilling holes for the camera and microphone on the back. Since the bird feeder is already assembled, it's easy to attach the camera by just drilling holes for the camera. Once this is done, I've made it so that I can insert the camera from the backside. This way, I can easily connect the cables for the battery supply to the board. This is a super easy bird feeder with the camera. Now, what we need to talk about is a camera function. When the camera is in operation, if it finds a bird, it should record. This should be saved to the SD card and it should include not only video but also audio. It should also be possible to check the live video via RTSP at any time. So, how can the camera recognize the bird and trigger it? As you know, YOLO is an object detection framework known for its speed and accuracy. There are many versions open so far, and the latest version that can be used on AMB82 Mini is YOLO V7 Tiny. I used this to complete this project. I will show you how to create a custom YOLO V7 Tiny object detection model that runs on the AMB82 Mini. All the scripts are on the project GitHub, so you can refer to them. Here, I will show you what steps are required. FYI, YOLO version 7 is an object detection algorithm that was released a few years ago, so I recommend using Python version 3.8. It's convenient for you to use this since my branch contains all the scripts you need. It looks like all the Python packages required for YOLO 7 have been downloaded. First, we download the bird dataset using Kaggle Hub. This script automates the process and presses everything into a bird dataset folder. Once downloaded, we organize the dataset into train and validation folders for both images and labels. This structure is required by YOLO. Our dataset may include multiple classes. This script filters only the class bird and remaps it to class 0 so we have a single class model. Now we train the model using a shell script. This sets the image size, epochs, and batch size and launches training using bird YAML. I don't have a GPU, so I trained using CPU and it took about 2 hours and 30 minutes under these conditions. Get one test image that was not used in training or validation through Googling and test whether object detection works well with the trained model. In such a static test, you should be able to see almost perfect results. If your model doesn't recognize a bird in an image, try training again. There is something wrong. It is important to check so that you can easily debug the issue later if it occurs. Before uploading to Realtek's online AI tool, we reparameterize the model using a special script. This flattens the layers and prepares it for quantization. You need to compress the prepared PDF file so that you can upload it. Finally, we upload the deployable PT file to your text AI model converter. Select your V7 Tiny, unsigned integer 8, select the compressed PT file, and 460x460 input, and upload one test image. You can use one of the images used for training. You can download the neural binary file for AMB82 Mini via email you entered. Create a folder called nn_mdl on your SD card and copy the downloaded file to the folder on your SD card and rename it to yellowv7_tiny.mb. Finally, we need to prepare the Arduino AMB82 Mini project. This is based on the example project, so we can easily modify only the necessary parts and reuse them. This example can be used for face recognition as well as several versions of YOLO. I prepared the model based on YOLO version 7 Tiny, so I chose customized YOLO version 7. As I mentioned earlier, there is already built-in model for YOLO version 7 Tiny, so you can use it. It works good. When an object is detected, it will automatically record for 10 seconds as an MP4 file on the SD card. If there are still objects detected, it will continue to create MP4 files. This example also supports live viewing via RTSP. Therefore, if you enter the ID, SSID and password for the local network in advance, you can easily view the live stream on your mobile device or laptop. Finally, if you look at the object class list, you can see that only one bird class is defined. This completes all the work on AMB82 Mini. I always find it exciting to test the devices I have made. There have been times when I worked hard on them, but they didn't work and times when they broke during testing. In this project, the main character is the bird. The bird has to come. If the bird doesn't come, not only can we not be sure that the device is not working as intended, but everything I have tried so far may have been in vain. On the first day, I ran the device from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m, but I couldn't see any footage on the SD card. I thought maybe I had placed the bird feeder too high up. The next day, I left it running for 12 hours from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. This time, I placed it a little higher than the ground. Also this time, I sprinkled some bird seeds in front of the bird feeder to make sure I could capture some birds. I really needed birds to complete this project. After 12 hours of shooting, I was finally able to check some MP4 files on the SD card. The camera recorded the footage after detecting the bird. I'm so happy with this. This works well and seems like it could do more projects. Anyway, that's for today and I will come back with more fun projects.